what we're doing here is we're bringing this corner back to an inside one-half, the free safety out to the close side one-half, the soft squat technique here. We're blitzing the strong safety, running the bullets underneath, we're ramming the end, and we're running the nose guard, Richie or Lenny, away from the closed top, and we're working outside the jet contain. And, you know, with this, we're playing a curl flat technique over here, and nine. It gives you a way, if you're getting a lot of eye back running and everything that way, that you can get a chance to overload the run right now when they're handing the ball to the tailback deep. Versus the slot formation. Versus the slot formation, and look, the backer walked away here. You got the corner blitzing here. And the corner blitzing, the strong safety in the flat, and the free safety working back to this one half. And if you had a wide number one, which is what I had drawn here, if you had a wide number one, the corner would be here, and now the strong safety would be the blitzer, and the safety comes back to one half of the field. So it gives you, let me explain that again. If you had the back out of the backfield out here, now the corner would be running the soft and the flat. The strong safety would be blitzing, all right? He'd be coming up and he'd be blitzing, the free safety coming back. Okay, Aaron, somebody left the checkbook in here. So that's the theory of the defense. It's very good versus your strong side running game, obviously, because you're getting an overload there. And people are running to the tight end side, running game very good that way. Any questions there on that? Now, the other thing that we'll kind of go through on the tape also, it's a tight sting two or three, and we'll hit this versus the run and show you some clips of it versus the run. Where now you're rushing both outside backers, and you're scraping and playing inside vertical hooks with these two players here, and we're playing half the field. And what we say two or three fourths, if it goes to a trips formation, then we'll check three coverage to the trips formation, and that's what's drawn here on the bottom.
Marvin, you want those backers looking like they're coming first?
If they got a number two to them, no, I like them to look like they're playing just base defense. If you got a number two to them, they can line up on number two, then walk in and come, so forth.
And then how about those inside backers?
We want to try and show the inside fire zone, or show something else to make to draw the attention of the guards as much as we can.
How about, do you ever step your backers up tight?
No, we didn't do much. I mean, really, we didn't do any of that, you know. So that's why we didn't want to be so obvious. The only time we're doing this is when we're, running this defense. So if we're coming up here, you know, he might come up and come. So I'd rather him act as though he's running that and just jumping up there on the guard. I'd rather him act like he's running the inside fire zone, rather than jumping up like you are. Okay, so what we're about on this tape here is that we should be in the... Here's close form two backer. Actually, this one right here. Now here's a run. Close form two backer. Here's a run away from the stunt. See it from behind. where they get behind, they get the backer cut off with the guard there. Basically, number 60 cuts off his backer. We're not bad. We put him up in the hole, but he's just so big, he can't make any get any movement on him. Here's second and four. It starts out versus the slot, and the corner was blitzed, and it comes over to the safety. Now here's a good look, and you can see this from behind, where the safety has got to get inside of it because it's a sky, or actually a cloud. He's got the corner outside it, so he can go and get inside that block there. See, he gets cut off out of the block. Because with the outside back, we're working down inside. He wants to work underneath this guy. How he would fit in the running game right there. Now here's a good look at a ball. We don't get spilled out there the right way. Again, you get into the cloud force. We're underneath. Now that safety wants to get it spilled as well. It's back into the scene.
So that outside backer, when he's pitching down hard inside, and if he gets down blocked on, are you telling him to fight pressure?
You'd like to fight pressure, yeah, not get caved all the way beyond the center. But it's going to be tough because he's going to, the biggest thing is don't show it early so it's a surprise. But the strong safety, you see his angle is not very good here. He's too far up the field. Now he's got to stop and come back almost.
Your safety is really the guy that's at fault. Linebacker's going straight outside of him.
Yeah, he's going to stack off of that, the outside backer, and then try and play off the safety. But the safety wants to be careful when play starts away, he doesn't get too deep.
So that safety coming out of the blitz, what do you tell him his aiming point is?
He wants to be off the hip of the tight end, but it's getting skinny. Now here it's against Arizona. We changed it up with the safety inside and the outside backer outside. And this gave us the same look that we had in cover six for special seven. Here's the inside fire zone versus the run. Now here's a good look at what you don't want to have happen. Okay, what happens here now? Take a look. As the end's already working out to contain, the guy that's got three receiver hook, we're in the check sky here, is the outside backer coming in. So as he comes in, he doesn't want to get up the field like the end's doing. He wants to fit and fold behind him there. You see that? So we get two people up the field. Well, that's the one thing about 95, when he's wrong, he's going to chase the ball. Well, he's still going to make a tackle, be pissed off. So we're coming here. He doesn't want to be up the field. He just wants to spit and fall right behind there. He makes the tackle, no gain. When he runs up the field, he gets in the end lane.
Did you have a sent down with both backers?
Yes.
They both like went the same hole?
Well, no. The only thing what happened was the first guy, when the guard blocks down, he goes to adjust off of it. The other one just comes back around. Because he's not going to go anyway with the ball coming back the other side. Here we make the tackle. Here we're going to make the tackle, but we're going to be wrong as well because we get too far off the field. As the outside backer, he should let the end clear and he should just sit and play behind it. Now the nose guard in this case is coming around what we're running here, but he makes the play. Later on, it's the same thing that broke down. The biggest thing you're seeing here is, I think, the effectiveness. Now, there's an occasional 5-yard gain, 6-yard gain, but you see the effectiveness of what we were doing here versus the run as well. I mean, it still averaged less than 3 yards a carry.
What down is this that you're...
First and second down. Things where they may pass, but you know, you're still looking for, I mean, they may run, but you're looking for a little bit more pass, maybe. Now here's out of like a 4-2 look. I don't know what you call it. We call it a slide. But we got the nose guard over on the guard. This from behind. So nose guard's going to the B gap to his side. Back is coming first. The other back is coming around. Mm-hmm.
with all that great lights, or you get to the other side of the line of scrimmage, and then they'd be falling out down there, Jesus.
Yeah.
Makes you feel like you're pissing in the wind sometimes.
Which linebacker model do you have? Is your pen trailer in on that?
Same, the guy the same size as the nose guard. Again, you could change this up, obviously, because you got a balanced deal. Tried to bring an open side. And this is again, we set. You can, you know, mess around once you understand, get the concept down. Tried to bring open side safety.
The weak kick out.
Yeah. We never got him through a clean. Tried to hold the Mac backer up there to hold the tackle. The only thing about when you start involving your safeties in it, you got to have some checks. So here was the check out of it. Just exchange that in the back of the safety and the inside backer to the weak side. So that's why the inside backer is now coming. So here again, we got it checked. But we get some indecision about what we're doing when he goes in motion. Okay, here we're rushing to both outside backers. Two or three versus trips, man. It's a tight sting, two or three. So cover two, stays two. There we hit a seam. See this from behind. They get the onside backer cut off. Or actually soft in the backside guy misses the tackle. Backside guy misses the tackle. Now here's just blitz zone rushing two guys from the side. But against the Raiders, we called it differently because of the way they were setting up formation one. So we open side corner fire, bringing the open side corner. Here's an over reduction sparrow. So we started out and we were over to the right with the three technique to the right and take the tight end in motion. And we're blitzing the backers off that side. Now here we get outside of a crack and opens up that seam. We talked about the crack replace earlier, the perimeter run. You'll see this here, we get outside of a crack. So we lose the inside seam and the inside fill position, plug position.
Okay.
So there's a, again, a couple of examples of, you know, those pressures that we talked about. The 52 buster we talked about, basically what we're saying here is we're going to go strong and weak. We've got the dime lined up here now with regular people, vertical hook, and then their responsibilities. Over here now we've got a slot, so we're set this way. And like that. If it were a... get to different formations here with the split out here with the halfback split out would be a line, kind of like I was showing you earlier. And down here where you get into your three receiver formations and so forth, down here, let me raise that up. But again, it was a strong and weak coverage based on the formation. Strong and weak coverage based on the formation here, which is three wide formation. And then the zone automatic that we talked about. Boy, we're quarters here when it's 2-2. And when it goes to trips, we're going to play a Ralph or Larry. In this case, it's a Larry to the left. And as it works out there, it all kind of, versus 2-2, motions across, we go Larry, 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 and we go into this zone here. So if it goes to 40, from 40 quarters concept to a 3D concept with the motion. And those were the two base things. Going to be called mainly versus run, or in the case of run, to try to stop the run. Now here, these guys are using a two-back formation. So you see the whole player coming up, the backer, the dime running with motion, the nickel is staying on too strong. Backer's working outside leverage here. He's going to help him inside. He's got the tight end.
He's just wrong.
Yeah, he's working to help him. If the back blocks, then he's free to rock. See, this was a 3rd and 4, so we're up in there. This was a call we're going to make a lot on 3rd and 3 to 4. See the safety walk up. Got two backs in the back coat, so we play up in and out. Here we're playing a little different. This we're playing a pass on Tim Brown. We're playing a double on Tim Brown. And you see us make the pass there. He's in the slot. Right back to him. Tim Brown's in the slot. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the double guy to Tim Brown. So we got this guy working with outside leverage, him hanging deeper. These guys got the backs, and now we're going to double. So we take Tim Brown away. So with the extra player, what you can do in there, if you're playing against somebody that's a good receiver, has a good receiver, you basically can double him, do whatever you need to do, you know, with that guy. Two backs that will be coming up and playing true hole. There you see the backer get beat underneath, but he's got the help there sitting there waiting. Get from behind. See, he goes to outside leverage there, but you know he's got whole help. He's sitting inside there. Flip the back, so we change the leverage there. Okay, let's go to a different coverage. We played it a little different versus Buffalo. I'll go to the next one. Because of who their player is, wanted to make sure we got somebody covering him. We cover him with the safety on the outside a lot of the time. And made sure that we got him covered. And that's why we use the term squeeze. He's at home and played normal. Here's a run with it. And why that's in this, should be in this part. But you can see what we were talking about earlier as far as gap responsibility versus the run from behind. Right here, he's got to keep coming to the A gap. He keeps coming inside. See, Kevin ends up stopping. We get knocked out of the gap and we're soft. They get a seam there.
Do you have a gap responsibility on run?
Who's that? The safety coming up? Yes, the A gap.
A gap.
The A gap.
So if he reads it's run, he's coming now.
Right, want him to keep coming. And again, we try to coach him based on formation, what level to be at when the ball's snapped. See, against these guys, there's more run with the back offset, so he's getting up there a little bit more positive. Most of the time with the back offset, we never be up there that positive. See, he's getting up there on the outside of Thurman. The backer's got the inside because we wanted to put the better matchup with the DB on the outside. Okay, here's the two cover. Now, what wild means is we're going to play inside leverage on number two.
Is that something, just to interrupt you, is that something you do a lot when you face a team that has a good back?
Right, yes, it is.
Flare, like
right.
Thomas?
Particularly if it's a third down guy. Who else did you say?
I meant like Thomas, Thurman Thomas.
Yeah, like him.
Yeah. An example like him.
Yeah, he would be, you know, him, Metcalf, guys like that, Harmon. We did a lot of that kind of stuff because you want to make sure on third down, 5 to 6, that you got that guy covered.
Instead of having a linebacker, you have
right. We give the safety the outside and let the linebacker play the inside a lot of the time. Now, this is two deep coverage here. You can see that's what we call wild, which means we're going to run with two. One of the few passes in 4 years we've let get in that window back there in two coverage. go, here's a good look at it. See, now, I talked earlier today about when the when that, that corner on that side, if he had number two up the field, how he can go ahead and fall up the field more. You see, this is a good example here. He's got no nothing else to play, so go ahead and fall off the field.
And that's safety. You're just telling him to play between one and two?
Between one and two.
22 yards deep.
Mm-hmm. That's the starting point, is 22 yards deep. Two's up the field, so now I can play softer. Here's a good look at the screen. You got outside in with the cloud force player. You got the inside hook dropper on the point. You got the inside out player and the chase lineman.
On that motion when the guy turned away, he's not making any.
We changed strength there, and we shouldn't have, I think. Because Dion was in that game. This is late in the game. Here's the change of strength for this nickel running. See, runs. Again, cover two, working inside cover two. We'll go to another coverage here. And that's with Wild, which is a little different than the Buster. There's an adjustment we make off the coverage based on what they were doing prior to the game, you know, during the week. You see how many snaps, I mean, cover two has been a big part of what we've done, particularly on third down. How many snaps there are of them. This was last year, and there was more of it this year. I just feel like it puts more pressure on the quarterback when you're playing cover two. You know. Down the field and dumps it off.
Back here. Harvest, so if you guys think that you could stop their run without going to that eight-man concept, would you play
more two
all the time?
So again, here's two down the field. Now, the corner's got to come off this guy. See, he's weak side. You see on the strong side here at the bottom, how we're getting these routes matched up on the strong side. We're working over two, we're staying on one. But on the weak side there, we ought to be passing, exchanging the route off. It's a good job by the backer. But the corner's getting too tied up with number one coming in. See, as soon as he goes to the flat, the backer walls off, but the corner should be sitting there. Here they're changing strength. Strength here. Backer's now running with the middle read. It's a good shot of it there. Again, look what you get. That number two guy just matched up. So much easier. See the corner sinking on one. You're all over number two. Okay, here's zone auto. This will be two and two, so it'll be in quarters. You see it's back pedal out.
Are you checked to this if it was really long?
Well, we would call this. You know, check. When we call zone auto, if it's two and two, we're in quarters. If it's any version of trips, it'd be three. And this would be something we play with generally longer yardage for the end of the game, into the half stuff. We play more of this. Again, you got everybody with vision underneath. You get a chance to rally on the plays. It's just putting a spy on the quarterback. We're doing the same thing, or a spy in this case with Buffalo on the screen. We wouldn't want to spy the quarterback. We're spying the screen back. Thurman Thomas. Spy on the screen. Now he ends up covering by the backfield, which we didn't want him to do. It's just this. Now we're getting just 54. We're playing quarters all over the board. And so this is just going to stay in quarters regardless of the formation. there are trips here. Your 40, we're running, we're staying trips. Now he becomes three receiver hook, he's backside. Then you got all the routes, and they end up hitting the weak. And we ought to play that better at corner. Go to the zone auto. All right, 55 is man under. To sit and get inside position and run the trail position.
Okay.
How much of man under do you play, Bob?
Played quite a little bit more this year to complement what we were doing with the other coverages. Dom wasn't a big fan of him before. We didn't play as much prior to because he always thought you gave away the press out, you know, like they're completing right there, and which is obviously a weakness in coverage. We played quite a bit more this year. Just as long as we could cover the tight end and make the match on the back, then we would be comfortable playing it. But obviously, you know, the weakness of it is, like here, the obvious would just get Novacek inside.
They motion across, would you stay with it or bump it?
We would stay with it, depending on, you know, it was a week-to-week thing, depending on who it was. Most of the time we'd stay with it, and then if it went to an outside guy, then we'd bump the outside guy out. But we wouldn't bump the interior guy much. Let's go to show you just some of the Ralph Larry's safety zones. Okay, here's a concept that we used. And we called it odd 55. And we got into a three-man look. We put Greg out as a rusher. We gave Chad the back, and we let him pressure rush on the quarterback. And it's been something that's been good. We played the 55 coverage. See Greg walk up. Chad's got the back, so he's just going to follow. So we're getting almost with the looks of a five-man pressure. See, he steps up. He now works under. He's got the back, which he's got to be more careful. Obviously, and he ends up catching a tip ball against this. Now, 3-2-55 was just another version of the double. Thurman Thomas, we're in and out with Thurman Thomas with the two with Chad and Greg. Okay, here's the odd 55 again, where he's got the back. Here's another good pitch up right here. Should be. Okay. thought we had one on and what we were doing, and I'll just show you here on the overhead. Take and slide our tackle out, tackle here on third down, this would be our end. We take our other end here. We take the backer, aligning to the back, okay? Rush him under, and basically just conform man contain rush. But give him, exchange him responsibilities with this guy, and keeping that guy out here, having him sugar up on the guard. So you're taking what was a lineman type for us, basically an end rusher, but he happens to be one of our linebackers, and putting him, sugaring him up on that guard so they can't double read out. Hold him on the guard, and then as the tackle works inside, he's gonna stun off of that. Give him the ability to work underneath the back if he blocks him, and him scrape and have the back and get an extra rush.
Like a late blitz.
He's just gonna let it happen at the line, take a step, and then work behind it. And so you're getting a five-man route, and you're playing man under. All right, so you're playing man under too deep. So you're getting everything covered, but you're getting the extra blitzer, you know, on the quarterback, obviously. Playing man under, man, deep half. You're getting the extra rusher, which is good, you know, which works out great, what you're doing. And that's, you know, that was one of the things that we did out of that look. Talk about some, go through the other things tomorrow, but that was a base coverage as opposed to really a pressure, and it was something that's been pretty good for us by utilizing those guys and get them to dictate protection, you know, and then take it and work the stunt, work our games away from the protection there. Well, is there anything else that I can cover for you now? What I want again tomorrow morning is just cover the third down pressures. Basically, that's it. I mean, I've been through everything. Yes. We're getting a lot of empty. The thing that we found this year, all right, we're set here, and say we're in three coverage, all right? We're actually the strong safety set here, corner, free safety, backer, corner, backer, backer, and they empty it out this way, okay? The best thing that you can be in is he's working to the curl flat. He can cheat and work to number three. All right? Because most of the time what you get is you're going to get something like this, him working up the field. He may be hooking inside. So you're going to get the combination of a flat, a hook, and outside here. So we're getting outside here. We're working into this. And we're being able to play with that backer between the two areas. And cover three for us really worked better than anything we were doing. Because we still had this matchup over here where we got basically a 3-on-2. And then we were pushing and getting that matchup over there with everything. And so as we got teams that started emptying more against us, we found out like we got a lot of this. We found out that the best thing we could be in was just matching this up here, like that. Just having those players play to what they're doing with the formation, whether they're doing it from there or whether they're releasing him out of the backfield like that, just playing and overplaying it like that. Because you still had on the backside your strong safety, your corner, and your free safety, and an inside backer who has nothing to play. So if they do, you know, try to push an option back against you, you still had the inside backer there waiting on it. And so that was one of the best things that I mean, and one of the most simplest, obviously, because you're where we were going to be because we're open rushing. We open rush so much, we're in a lot of three cover anyway when they do that. And so when they do that, it's just a matter of getting these guys to match up and play the route over there. And because what people, why people like that against us, running the blitz zone stuff, they're getting a chance to throw the football to one of those two guys. And this guy's got a wide, and the guy that's coming got to come all the way from over here to get that guy. To say you're rushing these two guys here, so this guy's got to come all the way over to get number three. If we're rushing those guys off there, they're widening the strong safety out of there with number two, and now they're turning number three away from. So it was a good, you know, that was how people were trying to take advantage. If we were running the tilt fire zone, where we're bringing the guys off that side, two linebackers, they know that the backside linebacker had to play number three. And that's how they were trying to work against us. So we saw quite a bit. If we developed a tendency to come after somebody during the game on a certain down, first down or second down, with those pressures, then we saw a lot more of that as the game went on. And so all we did is then we just stayed in the base defense. They get us in the three coverage, and now we could be adjusted and play that.
What if you had cover two called and they went empty?
They went cover two. And let's just say we had strength over here, so we're rushing this backer. Okay. BM. If we got empty here, we took this to over here to what we call rock, which we're going to cheat it to like a flood principle. And so now the corner's going to let this here go. He's going to curl out here, and the same thing as this backer had to overplay that because he knew this guy was going to back him up. And we had to sink this backer more inside. Okay, that was the coaching point. We sink that outside backer more inside here because we already got strength this way. But we're going to cheat the third dropper strong. We're going to cheat him that way and overrun that guy there. And the corner would basically take the flat and he would be playing on number one. So it's just, again, a matter of a coaching point of getting guys to understand what they were doing and where the weakness of the coverage was and playing to it. And kind of, you know, playing it into our hands. That was the biggest thing there. So it wasn't an adjustment. But why people were doing it is because we were blitzing two linebackers off the same side so much. We knew in order to do that we had to bring another guy over to defend that route. And that was what was most effective when we were just back playing base defense. Either two or three, we got the route matched up. Anything else? Alrighty, let's call it a day. Thank you.